Hey everyone, welcome back. This is Dan from DHTV, and today I'm going to be showing you how to use the focus mode on your iPhone 13, 12, 11, or pretty much any iPhone that has iOS 15. Let's get started. All right, so focus mode was added in with iOS 15, and it took the place of the do not disturb mode by adding extra features, and you'll be able to access focus mode anytime in your control center just by pulling down and tapping on focus. Now, if you don't know what focus is, you can see right here, it's basically going to filter notifications, signal to friends when you're not available, and hide distractions without missing what's important. So basically what that means is you can set up different options so that when you're at work or doing something important, certain notifications don't come through and certain ones do. So we're going to open our settings app and we're going to tap on focus. So this is where you're going to set up all of your focus notification settings. Now, there's a lot to cover here, so if you want to skip ahead, there's chapters in the description of the video, so you can skip ahead to exactly the section you want to learn. But we're going to take a quick look here, and I'll show you how Do Not Disturb is set up, as this one is by default already been configured. So when you open it up, and when you open any one of those options, you're going to see this sort of page here. You enable it just by tapping, and now it's going to enable. You'll see the little moon icon at the top, referencing the Do Not Disturb. But what you can actually do is configure this to allow specific notifications so you can add people, and when people call or send notifications from those specific people in your contact list, they're going to come through. Anybody else, you will not receive those messages. So if there's someone important, you need to make sure if there's a situation that you get those messages, they'll come through. You can also configure it from your favorites. So if you've set up favorites in your contact list, you can just add them there. And you can even set up specific apps that you want to allow when Do Not Disturb is on. So as it stands right now, none of the applications will actually send me notifications, but if I did tap here, I can choose from my whole set of applications in my app drawer. Now I'm using the iPhone 13 Pro, so I don't have a lot of my normal applications here, but let's say I just wanted to make sure my phone application came through when I have the Do Not Disturb feature on. I've now added it right there. Also, we have time-sensitive options here. This is going to tie in to applications that have time-sensitive notifications, so like calendars or reminders and things like that. So if you turn them on and a time-sensitive notification, for example, leave for work at this time or a wake-up notification, something like that, it's going to come through even if you don't have it on that list. So you can get really customized with how this is all set up. We'll just go back to the main page here. So as it stands right now, if I turn on Do Not Disturb, I'm going to have nobody allowed in my contact list to call me or get a hold of me. I do have specific apps that are set up, which is the phone app, meaning anytime my phone rings from anyone, it's going to come through. And I'm also allowing only notifications from time-sensitive events. So that's how my setup is right now. If I go down a little bit, you can see it says focus status. If you tap on that, you can turn the focus status off. So with the focus status on, it's going to notify others. So for example, this little picture right here is showing you what others that are in my messages app are going to see. So if they try to message me, this little bar is going to appear. So it's up to them. They can still send the message, or they can just wait until they don't see that option there. Now, I'm just gonna read you what this says here. Apps only know that you have notification silence. They don't know which focus you have on, so the name is never shared, but they can control how focus status is shown, and this is the example for iMessage. Now, when it's shared, right here, focus status is shared in apps when you have a focus turned on and after you give an app permission. So if we turn this off, there won't be any of these notifications within any apps. It'll just be you that sets the focus to that way. Others won't know that it's on or off. So that's the status right there. I leave it on. It's no big deal. Home screen and lock screen options. If you enable this, you can hide the notification badges on home screen applications. And then custom pages here, if it's enabled, you can pick specific home screen pages to show when the focus is turned on. So if we do that, we can select from our home screen pages. Now, if you've never used home screen pages, you see these two little dots down here? You can actually hide some of these pages. And if you hold your finger on the home screen and tap on the dots, it shows you those pages that you have. So on page one, I have these apps. On page two, I have these apps. So if I had a section or a page that just had specific applications that I wanted for those specific focuses, I could then go into the home screen section here, tap on custom pages, and only select the second page. I tap done, and I go back. If I enable this do not disturb, now when I go to my home screen, I only have that one page. You don't see the dots down there anymore. If I scroll left, it takes me to my app library. And then that way you only have what applications you need for that specific time of focus. So it's cool that you can actually play around with it like that. It's not like it's taking the apps away. You can always access all the apps. You just pull down, search for them up top, or just use your app library. But it's just showing you on screen what you need for those focus times. So I'm just gonna turn that off for now. And the lock screen works very similar. You can dim the lock screen when this is on. So if you dim it and you have the do not disturb on, you're gonna see it's very dim, almost a black looking screen there. You can also show on the lock screen. So silence notifications may show up still on the lock screen. If you want those to be there, you can. You just basically turn it on. I'm gonna leave them both off for now. And then we have turn on automatically. And I like these because they're timed for what you're doing. So if you know that every day you wake up at 7 o'clock in the morning and then you have your morning routine, you can set a certain focus to turn on. Now for me, it wouldn't be this do not disturb focus. We'll go back a section here. Let's say it was a work one. So I can tap on work. Don't miss out. All these options here, you can read that for yourself. But basically, I could go through the process of adding the people for work, calls from for work. I'm gonna allow none right now. I can allow those specific apps. So let's say I want my FaceTime, I wanted my calls, and I wanted my maps, and I tap done. So those are the only apps I want to allow when I wake up, and you can see your focus is ready, done, and it looks exactly like it looked with that do not disturb section. So adding a schedule or automation, when we do that, we can select a specific time for this focus to automatically turn on. Because I get up every day to go to work at 7 a.m., I can just tap there. Set it to 7 a.m. And then when I get in my car, let's say it's 8 p.m. So I'm gonna turn it off at 8 p.m. I just wanna have whatever I wanna do for that hour in that particular time. I could even set up another one for when I'm filming videos here so that certain applications don't come through and show those badges and interrupt my videos. And let's say I film every day at like 7 p.m. I would set it to 7 p.m. to 9, and between those hours, it's gonna automatically silence those notifications for me, and I'll be able to do my video without even having to come in here and enable the one I want. So if I go down here again, I can set it to a specific location. See, so for example, when I arrive at work, or for example, when you open a specific application. So if you use Zoom, and you're doing Zoom calls because you're working from home now, you can set this to only turn on anytime you open that specific app. So Zoom turns on, you don't want to be disturbed anymore. You don't want any applications coming through. You set that. You also see that there is a smart activation option here. Now this one's going to automatically turn on work at relevant times throughout the day based on signals like your location, app usage, and more. You can test this one out for yourself and see if it does a good job. Because it's automated, it may kind of get in the way and not recognize everything the way you want it. I personally don't use this at all. I like to set them up so I know what's going on and have everything exactly the way I want it. So that's pretty much how you would use the focus. So we just set up work, and then at the bottom you can delete your focus just by tapping there and tapping delete, and we'll just turn it off for now. So those are the options that you have within the focus settings, and you can set up custom ones too. You don't just have to use the ones they have here. You can actually press the plus up top, and you have a few that you can choose from. But let's say I had a custom one. I'm gonna say this one's like my YouTube. So I'm gonna say YouTube on it. So whenever I film YouTube videos, and I'm probably gonna set this up for real for myself. And then you can select one of these options here to go along with the color. So it's gonna give you that sort of badge at the top about what you're doing. So I'm just gonna select this one here. Now you can see that we have a red sort of TV there or screen. We'll tap next. I'm going to keep this very simple. I don't want anybody to be able to contact me or send me notifications through this at those times. So I'm gonna allow none. And then here, allowed applications. If I really wanted to, I could, but I really don't want anything to come through. And again, you can go through the time sensitive options here as well. I'm gonna allow none as well. And again, just some information here. So we have YouTube set up here and I have my focus status on, name and appearance right here. We can change that because we customized this one here. We can add a schedule if it applied, but really my YouTube one is gonna be very basic. I just don't want any notifications to come through at all. I could have just left my Do Not Disturb the way it is like this, where Do Not Disturb on the Options tab should be basically with nothing. That's the Do Not Disturb kind of default. But I'm just gonna set one up as YouTube like that, and that's pretty much how you have your focus. After you have these focus settings set up based on what your notifications are, you're going to just open up your phone, you can pull down your control center here, you're gonna tap on focus, and you're just going to select the one that applies. So for me, let's say I'm filming my YouTube video right now, I tap on that, and I know that what I've set up means that there aren't gonna be any notifications coming through, and I'm good to go. You can also tap these three dots here, and it'll show you a little bit of features or a little bit of options here. So settings, we can tap on that, it'll open right up for you. But basically that's how it's going to work for you, and then you can just turn it on and off with a tap just like that. And you can even add a new focus for yourself right here and it'll open up in the settings application. So hopefully you guys understood this. It's a really good feature to give you more time to do the things you're doing. And if you find yourself sort of being distracted by your phone, this is a way that you can dedicate that specific amount of time to what you need to be doing. So let me know in the comments what you think of the new focus feature built into iOS 15 on your iPhone 13, 12, 11, 10. Also, feel free to ask any questions. I'm happy to help you out. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell notification box to be notified when I post new videos. And as always, there's a link to the full iPhone 13 playlist of tips, tricks, and tutorial videos to help you get the most out of your new iPhone. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.